both electricity and magnetism. Taken together, these four equations show that electricity and magnetism are really one and the same. And it gets better. You can use Maxwell's equations to come to a super crucial insight. Now, to do that, we'll need to use a different version of Maxwell's equations. These are the integral form, but there's also a differential form. In calculus, differentiation and integration are complementary operations, much like multiplication and division. And you can write the equations in either way, kind of like you can say C equals A times B, or you could equivalently say that A equals C over B. Well, let's start with the differential form of Maxwell's equations. Suppose you take these equations and study them with both the charge and the current equal to zero. That means we set both J and the Greek letter rho to zero. So let's do a little vector algebra. Now, don't worry too much if you don't follow this derivation in detail. So what we do is we do the same thing to both sides, just like any algebra problem. We start out by taking the bottom two equations and putting one of those upside down little triangles with an arrow over it on both sides. That upside down triangle is called the del operator, by the way, and that little X is called a cross, and the little dot between symbols is called a dot. The del operator is a way to take the derivative of a field, like the electric or magnetic field, in three different directions, x, y, and z. The dot is a way to multiply two vectors together by independently multiplying their x, y, and z components. And finally, the cross is a little bit harder to visualize, but it's another way to multiply vectors, with perpendicular vectors resulting in a big number, and parallel ones resulting in zero. Then move the del operator to a different location in the equation, which is perfectly fine. And we can substitute from the original Maxwell equations for the right side. After that, we can use a mathematical identity. Mathematical identities are equations that are true all the time. So we can replace the del cross E, or B, term with this Messier-Moulding equation. After that, we can use Maxwell's equations to substitute in from the del dot E and del dot B, both of which happen to be zero. After that, we can get rid of the minus signs and voila. These equations look a bit scary, but what they have on the left is the spatial variation of the electric field or magnetic field, and on the right they have the time variation expressed as a second order partial derivatives. This is a classical wave equation. These two equations show that both electricity and magnetism are waves. If we look at the term in the front of the left-hand side in an epsilon naught, see, I told you they see them again. If you multiply them together, you look at the quotient's numerical value, you see that it is 1 over the speed of light squared. So let's then make that substitution too. Think about what that means. It means that light is related to both electricity and magnetism, and also that light is a wave. In short, what Maxwell did was to prove that light is an electromagnetic wave. I should probably pause for a moment and let that sink in. Light is an electromagnetic wave. The electromagnetic wave oscillates just like any other wave. Further, the electric and magnetic components both travel with the same speed, which is the speed of light. This animation shows the basic idea. From Maxwell's equations, we can derive a wave of electricity and a wave of magnetism. In our efforts to find a unified theory of the universe, this is an incredible achievement. Not only did we show that electricity and magnetism are the same, we also found that light was electromagnetism. We haven't proven it yet, but we can also use electromagnetism as a basis of chemistry. Unification of electromagnetism isn't our final tale, but it's a biggie. And it's also a great story because of how modern it is. Moreover, later, in the 1960s, scientists were able to unify all of electromagnetism with the weak nuclear force. We'll tell that tale in Lecture 8. But it's really worth your time to sit back and think about electromagnetism, which is already one of the greatest and highest impact scientific accomplishments of all time.
Lecture 3, Particles and Waves, the Quantum World.
Maxwell not only unified electricity and magnetism, he also showed that light is electromagnetism. But what is light, exactly? Well, thankfully, few of us have ever been hit by lightning. We've at least seen it splashed across the sky. Combined with our experiences with static cling, magnets, and light, which are representative phenomena of electromagnetism, we all have at least get a basic feel for the knowledge embodied in Maxwell's equations. Although we all have personal experience with electromagnetism, our experiences are actually pretty limited. That's because our senses have a fairly limited scope. We're concerned with objects from, the size of a grain of sand to the journey to the next meal or watering hole, say, a millimeter to tens or hundreds of kilometers. We have a personal familiarity with temperatures ranging from a polar vortex to a roaring campfire, say temperatures from as low as minus 30 Celsius to may